Marion High School boosters are always there to support the students of Marion High in all their activities. Parents, grandparents, patrons of the district, and anyone wishing to support young people striving to excel are welcome to join the Warrior Nation. Buy some Warrior gear and show your colors. Come to a play, a game, a concert, or any other activity. Help boost the Warriors.
Check out Marion County Ace Hardware on Highway 56 north of town for all your home improvement, camping, lawn care, and other hardware needs. Marion Ace Hardware is a member of the largest retailer-owned hardware cooperative in the industry. They are committed to being the helpful place by offering knowledgeable advice, helpful service, and quality products. Helping you is the most important thing they do every day at Marion County Ace Hardware. Carlson's Grocery supports the Marion Warriors, the Center Cougars, and all the people and organizations of the area. Carlson's offers a full-service grocery store with small-town friendliness and big-city selection. Newly remodeled, Carlson's Grocery has a great variety of all your favorites. Fresh produce, an outstanding deli, and mouth-watering catering are also available at Carlson's. Carlson's Grocery, everything you need right here at home. Hannah Ford Abstract and Title is a trusted name serving people in the region since 1871. They provide abstracts of title and title insurance, along with real estate closings for your transactions. With the latest in leading-edge computer technology, Hannah Ford Abstract will continue to be dedicated to providing the very best of service for years to come, and to supporting students of MHS. Marion Dye and Fixture is a Bradbury Group company that manufactures a wide range of custom dyes and fixtures for metal forming applications. The dedicated employees and management place an emphasis on quality. Marion Dye and Fixture is a proud supporter of the Marion community.
Donahue Manufacturing continues the tradition of quality trailer manufacturing which began over 50 years ago. Located just outside of Durham, Kansas, Donahue builds a full line of agricultural, industrial, and utility trailers. Continuous product evaluation and quality improvements ensure that you get maximum value for your trailer purchase. Please visit our website at donahuetrailers.com or call us toll-free 1-800-457-7406. When there's work to do, Donahue.
Welcome to Lumberyard in Hillsborough, Kansas, in Marion County. My name is John Heffley, president and owner, and I'd like to welcome you and show you some of the services we have to offer here. We are a full-service lumberyard. We do paint, lumber, hardware. We have free delivery in Marion County. We have a lot of options to show people. We have a showroom for kitchen and bath. We are just a full service, and we'd love to have you come take a look at us and shop Marion County.
Ladies and gentlemen, to the sack. We got Darren Neufeld, Jerry Smith, Jay Smith, Gene Winkler, and the old producer, Mike Powers. And we're here tonight. We got a game between Hutch Trinity and the Marion Warriors. I think maybe this could be a tough game for the kids. We're going to have to rebound really well. They've got a 6'8 kid that plays real well inside. And our record is we got 6 wins, and I think they only have about 6 losses. So it could be a tough night. But if our kids come out and play with a lot of enthusiasm, we might be able to get it done. What do you think, Darren?
Well, I have not had the privilege of watching Hutch Trinity play all this year, but with the big kids inside, I know Angel Martinez is a great athlete. He's going to play some perimeter as well as kind of down in that forward position. So we're going to have to rebound well. That's the whole thing.
Yeah, we've got to block off the boards and not give them second chances.
No second chance points.
Well, so we'll see how it goes. Start out in a 1-3-1 zone. Well, we're getting to the shooters in a hurry.
Yep. So far, Mermis is Mermis is doing a good job so far, keeping the big guy fronted.
Yeah.
See if he'll be able to keep it up full.
If he stays inside, they can almost match up and play a man-to-man inside there, kind of like a diamond
diamond and one.
Okay, I guess I bet they're setting up a press.
They are setting up a press.
Well, we've got some kids that can jump. I don't know if we can jump 6'8" worth or not. But
well, if you keep on your backside, it doesn't matter.
Stupid can get up in the air.
Oh.
Nice pass.
Pass. Baldwin couldn't quite handle it.
Okay.
Went off his hands.
That's another thing we can't have a lot of is turnovers. We can't have empty possessions with no shots.
Starting to impress ourselves here. Breaks.
Well, we got back. We're in good shape. All right, they have a turnover. One turnover apiece.
They're picking us up in a man now. Ooh. Nathan took it up strong, thought he was going to get contested, and then didn't. That time Trinity beat us down the floor.
That is one thing I think this year we have some problems with him, which surprises me because we've got a lot of speed out there. But it's been a number of games that it seems like we get beat up and down the floor a little more than what we should. I don't know if it's because our guards are getting caught underneath the basket or what, but we don't do a good job of transition defense. And it doesn't.
You know, if in our offensive end, we do end up with three to four guys inside the paint on almost every time. So getting back is, we're packed in underneath most of the time. So
That's a good move by Baldwin. We're missing our head coach tonight. He's been sick, and the doctors would not release him to come to the ball game today. So that's got to hurt a little bit. I know Duke has a little problem when Coach K's not there, so figure this is about the same, isn't it? Well, let's get on the board here, Nathan.
Attaboy. And Alex went down. Picking him up in half court.
Changing defenses back and forth a little bit there. Trying to speed him up a little bit, see if they can play with a little speed.
Ooh, nice job, Mason. It'll be interesting to see if Mermis can play with that much intensity the full game.
Yep,
so far, like I said, he's still... Still getting around in front of the big kid, but they're doing a lot of moving.
I don't think we've mentioned our starters. We started out with Mason and Peyton Heidebrecht, Zach Stuplik, Nathan Baldwin, and Blaine Mermis. Those are the starters for tonight.
Oh, they left the backside open. Oh, hey.
Oh.
Well, that's a tap-in for Trinity.
It was almost.
I don't know if that fully cleared the cylinder there.
Another turnover. But that's one thing they got to be careful with, that 1-3-1. This wing guy's got to drop down here, and he didn't, and wide open.
Yeah, Angel
should have had the layup.
Was wide open on the backside corner.
Yeah, and that's where the rebounds are going to hurt us, too.
So far, I would not really worry about the guard play at Trinity being the one that hurts us.
Right now, it hasn't.
That's the first three-point shot they've taken tonight, and he buries it.
Number five.
by Max Pritchett.
Rick, we're asking across the timeline.
Yeah, they're playing this man now, huh?
They went to the man that last time, or a couple times down. Go. Mason shot off the mark.
Yep.
Yep. Zach's feet weren't quite set.
I gotta agree with that.
He was moving to get in a good position, but just didn't quite get there in time. Two subs coming in, Chase Stringer and Noah Dalrymple from the Warriors. I think that's one thing they're really going to have to, if they're going to keep up this intensity, he's going to have to rotate players a lot tonight.
We'll see how Chase Stringer does with the guy.
Running jumper by Trinity, but then he was able to clear his own rebound. Five for the shot again, and second one.
Two in a row. And we got a Tampa State Bank timeout. All right, we gave you a little pregame, and that was brought to you by Central National Bank. And our first quarter sponsors are Eagle Communication, Prairie Land Partners, Marion National Bank. Our three-point sponsor is Case & Son Insurance. Our timeout sponsor is Tampa State Bank. And we are broadcasting from the broadcast area supplied by Lanning Pharmacy. Good place to go get your drugs. Prescription drugs. Prescription drugs.
Sure, Tracy, I'll appreciate you putting that qualifier in there.
Yeah, I thought maybe I ought to. All right.
Okay.
We're going to press this some more.
They're in a man press.
There you go.
Down the lane by Stuklik. Oh, too bad he couldn't get that one to drop.
Yep.
Foul if you're going to the line for two.
I think if they're going to win this game, they've got to get a lot of points in the paint. They're getting a lot of shots in there. They're just not making as many as I'd like for them to make.
Yep,
and you can't miss free throws.
Nope.
Got to relax out there. I saw them shooting before the game. I guess they couldn't miss a free throw. Made them all in practice, I guess.
Oh, missed the second one. Warriors now are in a 2-1-2.
Yep.
Guess he decided he wanted to protect those back corners a little more. Three-pointer on the way. Off the mark there. Dalrymple clears the rebound.
Good job. We can get rebounds, just got to block off. It's like a lot of things, that takes a lot of effort. Let's see, Evan Heidebrick snuck in on us. So he's out there now.
And their 6'8", just went to the bench for a break, so now would be a good time to maybe push it inside. We've got a much better size matchup. There you go. Nice rebound by Dalrymple. Moves it right back up and in for two.
Turn around. Find the ball, guys.
Once again, we're moving well in the zone.
Oh. That was a good shot.
They took it over the top of Stringer.
Nice job of coming right in the middle of the lane. That's good. That's a good press break. Pass the ball. Don't try to dribble it up. Get the ball to the middle.
Now Nice pickup by Dalrymple, and he gets it over off again. Pass wasn't meant for him, but he found himself with the ball in his hands and took it up strong. Five shooting again.
Okay, that's three in a row from that spot. We need to move him off that spot, don't you think?
I think if he scoots back anymore, he's going to be hitting almost NBA threes. Definitely showing he has a range from that spot.
Yep.
Stukely for three. Got it.
Oh, that's a Casey Sun three-pointer for Marion Warriors.
Turn around, guys. Turn around.
Yeah, we kind of turn around, kind of jog down, and we don't really know where the ball is, do we?
There he shot again. Man, missed that one.
I don't know if I would.
Two more subs checking in for the Warriors. Mason Peterson comes back in, and Mr. Zinn is checking in. Sam's first entrance into the game. Sam's in 2-1-2. Oh, that was a travel.
I think he gets the ball in there. He's going to be pretty tough.
Push it, Mason. Push it. Nice shot by Mason.
They got a foul on number 30.
Yes, number 30 moved.
Nice
in.
Block out by Stringer.
Actually, Chase was coming in. I don't think I've never replayed it. Here we go. Chase was coming in for the rebound, and the guy slid under him when Chase went up in the air. So.
Oh, okay.
Chase didn't end up on the front side, but he got the foul out of it. So. Three-pointer for Mason. No good. Nice rebound by Stringer. Nice pass to Dalrymple. Up and in. Off the glass.
All right. We've got a Tampa State back timeout for them. That's good. Well, it was 11-1 at one time. I looked up and I started to say, is that really the score? But I knew they were ahead, but I didn't realize they were ahead.
I even think it was.
We came back.
Oh, here's the replay from a little bit ago. Stringer's going to.
Okay, we got Stringer coming
Stringer's
around there.
Stringer's right in here.
Dalrymple gets the deflection and off the glass.
Not quite the same one though. You can figure the foul on, but we're getting good rebounds right now. That's the thing. We're moving inside and some second chance points.
Gonna give you our Warrior sponsors.
Oh, there it was.
Marion Auto Supply, Gambino Pizza, HRK Store, and KD Insurance.
Yeah, just on that replay. Yeah, the kid took out Stringer with an elbow. That's what it was.
Well, he was.
They might have gone to the monitor in the college game to review and see if that was a thrown elbow and got him out of the game.
Yeah. When he posts up down here, he kind of sticks an elbow in somebody's face.
Attempted lob to the big guy.
All right,
that
let's
should
get
be on
foul.
Them.
Dobbs called him 31 of Hutch Trinity. Jack Neal, his first personal 15 foul.
You know, they don't have... They don't have 30 checked in up on the big board. I'm not sure if he's got one or two fouls right now. I know he has at least one.
Yeah.
Nice movement by Evan. Oh.
Yeah, guys, you gotta catch those.
Need to get a white jersey over in front of them so they can't go clear to the basket.
Sam took the easy way out and tried to come from behind and missed him.
Nice pat, nice shot by Dalrymple. Boy, Dalrymple is having a nice first quarter.
That's a pretty
nice
good
first quarter.
That's pretty good. 14-20. 14 points, good. 20 is not so good. All right, on time. 1 second left to go. That's good. That was a good job. Okay. Our first quarter sponsors, again, Eagle Communication, Prairie Land Partners, Marion National Bank. Our second quarter sponsors are Triple R Hawley, Shelter Insurance, Peary Real Estate, and Marion Kiwanis Club. I see our old producer left us, didn't he?
Hey, I think he did.
He said he had a long day.
He said he wasn't feeling real well, and he decided to take the opportunity.
Yep.
Well, I think on that first quarter, you know, Dalrymple finished with 8 points on that first quarter. He really came in and sparked us off the bench. So that was a nice little pickup. Got some boards and got some good shots.
I like the shots we're getting.
Yeah.
I like the shots we're getting, whether we're making them or not. But
I said, I can't tell how many points, you know, right now, number five has had those 3 three-pointers. Is really the only single person on the other team, on Trinity's team, that's really beat us. And it looks like here starting the second quarter, he's not going to be in the lineup.
At the start of the second quarter, number 23, Nathan Baldwin, 12, Zachary Stupin, 5, Pink Heidegger, 32, Blaine Hermes, second for Marion.
Looks like we're back to the starters.
Yeah, we've got
quarter.
The starting people in there. Two fresh. Some fresh people in there.
Which I think, once again, I think it's going to be a big key to the rest of this game. Is you have to rotate the guys, get fresh legs in there. Dangerous pass by Mason. You know, I'd like to see him get the ball inside here to Blaine just to see what he can do with it. There he got it. Oh, and the foul. Oh,
oh, we're
jump ball.
Call jump ball.
Jump ball.
Blaine had his guy sealed off. It was the backside help is what got Blaine in trouble.
Yeah.
He actually had moved past the big guy.
Pass could have been a little better. He kind of had trouble hanging on to it, but that's catchable.
Looks like we're back in the 2-1-2.
We didn't block him off that time.
No,
Blaine
didn't block off well enough.
Didn't get him blocked off that time, did we?
Had two white jerseys below him, just didn't get backed into him to get him out of there. Well, now they've got him up there on the board. He's got one foul, and he's only got 4 points. Make it five. So once again, for Trinity, the guys that are on the floor right now, really, when you look at the scoring standpoint, we should be able to make a little progress here.
Yeah, but again, that second chance points, that hurt us. That's that's two offensive rebounds he's gotten.
Oh,
yeah.
Nathan got sped up a little too
much.
What
happens when you have your post people handling the ball coming down against the press? You got to maybe come to a stop and find somebody to throw the ball to. There's a reason why he's not a point guard.
Mason made a good move to get him moved down the floor, but then this was a little out of control to try to make that pass inside. I believe they're going to call that on Blaine.
Yeah, we're preoccupied with number 30, as we should be. Which is allowing an empty bubble in there somewhere, and they're taking advantage of it right now.
Yeah, Blaine's going to come out, and Noah Dalrymple's going to come back in for him. Yeah, on that last play, we actually had number 30 double team.
Yeah.
Left the backside open. Good rebound by Dalrymple. Back in a man. Nice move by Baldwin.
Pretty nice move there, yeah. Again, I like the shots we're getting.
Exactly. I think our shot selection, getting the ball inside.
Yeah, I like
it. We haven't taken too many,
ball.
Other than Stu taking a couple of long shots, we really haven't. Oh,
that's a travel.
We haven't really taken anything outside of maybe 10 feet.
Yeah,
Stu taking the three.
I think we had a three, but moving the ball well, we're getting shots inside. I kind of like that. We can get a stop, get some stops on defense. Oh, they could have called a walk on
Duke
that real easy.
Three. Ooh. Once again, Balrymple fighting for rebound. Didn't quite come down with it, but at least he was there. Nice clear by Dalrymple. Turning with the ball in the corner. Mason. Mason for two. Oh, we're going to call 3 seconds on Dalrymple. Evan Heidebrook checking in for Stuklik. Coach Edwards trying to find out what happened there.
Three sophomores and two seniors on the floor.
Still in 2-1-2.
Oh, hey, there you go.
Nice rebound, Noah. Didn't have him boxed out, but made him come over the top to get him. Sam's in, checking back in for Mason. Nobody picking up Heidebrick. Brings the ball from the front court. Evan with the drive and the two.
That's a good move. Nine, under control. Just kind of eased his way in there and took the shot.
Once again, the shot was in the paint. Got number five on the backside. There you go. Nice.
Good try, Sam. He about had that.
Noah did a great job that time coming from a long way away to make sure he broke down on number five to make sure he wasn't going to get an easy three-point shot out of that one. Fouls are 6 and 6.
So we'll
next foul either way, I'll start shooting.
Start shooting, yep.
Trying to spot up number five for a three-pointer on the far side. Ooh, boy.
Yeah, that could have been called something, I would have thought.
Yeah, that's a surprising no call. Usually that much contact's going to draw some kind of call. Nice inside move by Dalrymple. Can get the shot up over the big guy. Stringer with the shot. Heidebrick with the rebound. And draws a foul.
Good. Hey, what?
Could be doing 1-1 for Heidebrick.
I like the way we're hitting the boards, too.
Mason back in for Peyton. Evan's going to be shooting 1-1. We can cut a few more into this lead. There's the first one. There we go, starting to make the free throws. Down by four.
Never hurts to make those free throws.
Evan for second, knocks it down. Leads down to three.
We're not pressing full court anymore, but that's all right.
Staying in the 2-1-2. Steal out front. And a two by Mr. Peterson. Trinity by one.
Let's go. Get excited, guys, a little bit.
Stringer's having a little tougher time keeping number 30 on his backside compared to Blaine.
That's
but
right.
he had him up in his face enough that he made him take a bad shot. Yeah.
You're not going to block his shot anyway. Just put your hand in his face so he can't see the backboard.
Yep. Nice move, nice pass, and score by Dalrymple. Marion takes the lead, 24-23. Levin for three, got it. So it was a short-lived
lead. Spot over there must be.
Yeah, that's a hot spot.
Hot spot.
All four of their threes have come from that exact same spot. 2:14 left in the second quarter.
That was just kind of a pretty poor angle.
I kind of agree. Stringer pointed at number 30's foot. I think 30 actually kicked that ball on the way by.
Might have.
Just didn't get a call out of it.
No, 30 wanted that ball awful bad.
Going to get Dalrymple.
I think so.
That's his first, though. It doesn't hurt at this point.
Also on number 20, Marion Dillon, Dalrymple, his first personal 17 foul.
Now Trinity will be shooting this time, too, but 1-1 the rest of the way here in the first half.
Checking into the game for Marion, number 12, Zachary Stupin.
Trinity missed the second one. Still 2-point lead for Trinity. Minute 45 to go. Second quarter. Stuklik checked back in. Mason takes a shot. Dalrymple with the rebound. Stringer out front. Nice pass off. Mason for three. Ooh.
That'd have been nice. He's been shooting in tough luck the last two or three weeks. He really.
Oh, Dalrymple tried to get out there, and there's some tangled up feet.
He got knocked clear to the floor. Yeah, I don't quite understand anything about it, but anyway.
I think he got tangled up with some feet trying to get out there. Trinity back up by four. 50 seconds to go.
Had two people cutting.
Nice move by Dalrymple. Up and in.
There you go.
Nice pump fake underneath.
Play defense now, guys. You got
to
play both ends.
30 seconds to go. Down by two.
Don't jump at him.
Nice. Yeah. That traveling turnover.
He had Stringer buried clear behind the backboard. Yeah, that's all right. Let's go. We can take a last shot.
25 seconds to go. Trinity by two, 26-28. Peyton taking his time, bringing the ball to the floor here.
Don't take too much time.
Hands off to Stuklik, seven to go, six to go. Need to get a shot off, guys. Four, three.
Really? Did he shove off with his arm?
I didn't think so, but. Nice thing was, with no shooting foul, they're going to have to take a desperation.
Yeah, okay,
there, so.
We're going to clock off real quick here, guys. Got something coming on. Bye.
Molly said, I look up to my mom and dad. They have faced many trials and many hardships. But no matter what they've been through, they have always made sure us girls have what we need. I hope to one day be as accomplished as they are. When asked about her most embarrassing moment of high school, Molly said, "My sophomore year, I went down to the park to take pictures for prom, and my dress had a sequin top. Shelby Flawless and I were going to take a picture, and she jumped in my arms, and her lace dress got caught while coming down, almost pulling down my dress in front of everyone in the park. Then it took 5 minutes to get us untangled. My face is bright red from embarrassment."
Our first team candidate this evening is Nathaniel Lehman Baldwin, son of Laura Baldwin and Dan Baldwin. Nathan is a member of Marion Christian Church. Nathan has been involved in football 4 years, basketball 4 years, baseball 3 years, the musical 4 years, the play 4 years, forensics 4 years, National Honor Society 3 years, student council 4 years, and seniors 4 years. Nathan's advice to underclassmen is, actually do homework. It kind of helps. When asked what his most embarrassing moment was, Nathan said, "My most embarrassing moment of high school was basically my entire freshman year. I still have nightmares." When asked who he looks up to most, Nathan said, "I look up to my grandma. Although she is gone, she still impacts me every single day. She showed me how to be strong and caring and ultimately loving."
His church. He has been involved in football 4 years, track 4 years, singers 1 year, the musical 2 years, forensics 4 years, and FFA 4 years. Jeremy's advice to underclassmen is, even though it seems like a big deal, it doesn't really matter what others think of you. Don't ever let what others think stop you from doing what's right. When asked who he looked up to most, Jeremy said, "My dad. He has many attributes that I respect, but his selflessness is the most impressive. No matter where he is at or how many things he has to do, he will make time to help someone in need." When asked what his most memorable moment was, Jeremy said, "The moment when I broke the huddle in football by saying, 'Wildcats on three,' instead of 'Warriors.'" The life of gratitude and service. Giving has its own rewards. When asked who he looks up to the most, Kate said, "My grandpa Petey. He lived his life with a positive attitude and a servant's heart." When asked what his most embarrassing moment was, Kate said, not going to mention the full incident, but it involved a Taco Bell cup, a long bus ride, and a bump in the road.
The little helpers this evening are Allie Harshman, daughter of Jordan and Amy Harshman, and Trenton Sprouse, son of Matt Sprouse. Assisting the little helpers this evening is the 2016 Queen of Courts, King and Queen, Nicholas Duplick and Elizabeth Maya.
Will the King candidates please step forward? The 2017 Queen of Courts, King and Queen are Jeremy Hett and Tori Boyd.
Discussing here just, you know, over the halftime, and it seemed like if we can continue to get the ball in the paint and rebound like we've been rebounding, we didn't give them too many second chance points, but we outscored them. At one time it was 11-1.
So we outscored them the rest of the second half, 25-17.
You know, we keep that pace up, we can come out here with a win. As far as I know, both teams are starting the same five.
Actually, Trinity looks like that number five that knocked down those three-pointers early in the game. He is not starting in the second half. The other four appear to be the same starting lineup.
Yeah, five didn't start.
Oh, he didn't start?
No.
Okay.
So he'll be in probably pretty shortly, though.
Okay.
We'll go over our second quarter sponsors at Triple R Hauling, Shelter Insurance, and Harry Real Estate, and Marion Qantas Club. And we'll get back with our other sponsors here in just a little bit.
Trinity comes out in the second half, still in their man defense. Baldwin takes a 15-foot shot. No go. Trinity's pushing up the floor this quarter.
Like I said, if we can keep them getting blitzed real, real hard.
Oh, left him wide open. Mm-hmm. No defense there.
No defense there.
I mean, there was no defensive person there. No.
I don't know if we got screened or if we got blocked off or we just came down late.
Nice pass inside and count the basket. And he gets one.
Nice pass. Nice finish. See, I don't know. Stuklik, to me, if I was coaching, would be a matchup nightmare. He plays the guard position, and why, you know, pull the big people out and see if he can't post up those little guards that guard him.
Exactly.
He's 6'3 and jumps like a jackrabbit.
Exactly.
But for some reason, it just doesn't quite work for us.
Still 2-point game. Trinity ahead by two after Stuklik makes a 3-point play. Nice defense by Mermis and Mason, and with the steal. Better come help him. Better come help him. Oh, come on.
I don't. I, that's just uncalled for. That's a foul anywhere in the books.
Peyton was set for 10 seconds.
Yeah. And he didn't flop either.
Suklik on the drive. And a foul. Should have got a foul there, too. But we'll take the 2 points, go back up by one.
Okay. I'll take back the fact that I didn't think he was very strong. That was a strong move. Two people had their hands on that ball.
Well, he one had his hand on the ball. The other one had his arm.
Arm. But he still had to finish through contact. Oh, just stay
oh,
right.
Oh, man.
You know, if he'd have just stood his ground, I think that would have been a charge.
Yep.
Okay, we got a replay coming up. Oh, okay, yeah. Good job. Yeah, if he'd have just stayed right there,
I think. Yeah, I think I would have got charged out of that. You're right.
He ended up kind of spinning and.
Second in for Hutch Trinity, number 5, Matt Pritchard.
Angel knocks down both free throws, and Trinity goes back up by one.
There's a knack to drawing charging fouls. Let's keep the ball in the middle, guys.
Break the press. Looking to get the ball inside, but Trinity's got it packed in pretty good. Mason for three, got it.
All right, that was a Casey's son three-pointer. I couldn't see if he was back behind the line. I'm kind of shielded off there. Okay.
Martinez for three, doesn't quite go. Stuklik with the rebound. Mason pushing the ball up. Off to Heidebeck in the corner. Nice pass cross court. Pump fake.
No. Oh,
and Baldwin with the rebound and the putback.
That's good. That's great. We got a replay, I think, coming up here. We got a Tampa State Bank timeout.
Yep.
Okay. Oh, yeah, that's an easy three.
Easy three. Came down outside the line.
Yeah. All right. We got a Tampa State Bank timeout, and we got a four-point lead. Well, we didn't get blitzed right off the bat.
And so far, I don't think
we're moving the ball
30,
well.
30 has not scored any points in this half.
We're
five is back in, but he hasn't had a chance to shoot yet.
Yeah, we're hitting the boards hard, moving the ball.
On that last
rebound, dribbling it so much.
On that last rebound, Nathan was actually in there with four red jerseys.
Yeah.
And managed to come down with the rebound and take it back up strong.
By the way, we've given you some brief quarterly reports, and they were brought to you by St. Luke Hospital. We'll give you another one, even if it's just a score. He draws a lot of attention when he gets the ball in there, doesn't he?
Three guys collapsed in on him, left that long jump shot wide open from the baseline. Warriors cross the timeline. Past the corner to Mermis. Takes a shot, doesn't quite get it to fall.
I don't think that's quite his shot, but I'd much rather see us get in the paint a little bit.
Ooh.
Got a foul
Peyton
on
with a
Peyton.
Reach from the backside.
That's probably a pretty good foul. I think they're probably going to pick up at least two and maybe a three-point play on that one there.
Dalrymple in for Mermis, and looks like Evan Heidebrick is going to check in for Peyton. Staying in the 2-1-2.
A little more firepower.
Done us a lot better than that when we started out in the 1-3-1.
Watch him coming right back in. Coming right back in.
And that's that spot that he likes. That's four in a row from that exact spot that he has shot. He has not missed from that spot.
Wow. Be careful, guys.
Trinity back up by one, 3:50 to go. third quarter. That's far side to Mason for a three, a little short. It's a little outside of his range there.
Heat check. Now we need to not fall in love with those outside shots. And I know guards go, "Oh, we don't even get to shoot." Well, you know, if you're if you're winning the ball game, what difference does it make?
Three-pointer for number five again. Nothing there. Rebound. The 30 misses. A close putback foul on Dowler underneath.
Way to battle in there.
That'll be his second.
Way to battle.
Nathan's headed out, checking in Stringer. Stringer's now going to have the inside against thing number 30. Somebody didn't collapse around on that.
Yeah, we don't need to carry 30 all the way across the other side of the lane.
Nice pass up. Stringer pushed it right into the goal. Once again, didn't get back on that one. Kind of looks like we were looking at the first couple minutes of the game right now.
Yep.
Need to get back to working the ball inside like we were doing.
We were getting, we got a Tampa State bank timeout. We were getting those inside shots. We kind of got away from them a little bit. We had one there. We need to make those, but anyway, I haven't given third quarter sponsors yet. Marion Boosters, Marion County Ace Hardware, Carlson's Grocery, Hannaford Abstract. We had about three possessions where we didn't get inside and at least get inside and kick out, work from the inside out.
And yet down on the other end,
then,
during those same
possessions, they come down there and it seemed like They scored and had
4 points off fast breaks there.
Yeah.
And then the other two times they worked the ball around and got it into their shots. If they weren't in the paint, they were right outside the paint.
Hey, you know, I asked them if I could get some and they said it would cost me $5. I says, I don't have $5. I thought maybe, and I knew that MCTV doesn't have any, so I told them they were out of luck. I said, I got a quarter. This is, I'll give you one. Right here in the middle of my forehead. You guys couldn't hear that. I was talking to Gene. He says, I should have got my eyes painted up like the cheerleaders.
If it was a live broadcast, it might have been better.
Yeah.
Mason for another three-pointer off the mark.
I think Trinity's gone to a zone, haven't they?
Yes, they have.
They were that time, and maybe that's why we're not getting the ball, getting inside as much as we'd like to. Boy, that guy just.
Boy, that's twice in a row now. He is slashed to the basket and knocked it down.
Oh, Stu's got to be careful when he gets in traffic because he's so tall and he bounces that ball so high, it's pretty easy to get a hold of. Maybe we need just a little bit more patience. I don't know.
Nice pass to Dowler for cutting down the lane for two.
Get it to that short corner there, and that hurts, or the middle of the zone. That's where you can hurt the zone. We were just more patient that time and got a nice shot. We didn't settle for a long shot.
Dowler with the rebound.
Here we go.
Warriors down by 5, minute 15 go over. Bad pass.
Okay, we got away with that one.
Got lucky we didn't lose any points out of that.
Yeah. Or pick up a foul.
Evan for two.
Again, we come down, we work the ball, we get an inside shot. And next time we come down, we can't wait to shoot the ball from the outside.
Almost get a steal by Evan.
Two passes and boom, a shot goes up. That shot's there anytime they want it, so let's work the ball a little bit.
Zim checking in for Mason.
Okay.
Nice defense by Dalrymple, knocking the ball right back out of bounds. 54 seconds left to go in the third quarter. Warriors still down by five. High pressure by Zinn in the 2-1-2. Zinn got a little too high there, left the cutter in behind him. They got about a 10-foot jump shot that drops.
Let's see how patient we are this time.
At this point, you just need to go ahead and play for that last shot.
Might as well.
See if we can cut the lead back to five, or maybe even four. You can start working it in. 8 seconds. Nice drive by Heiderbrick. Can't get the ball, can't get the rebound.
Oh, go in. Oh, okay. All right, that's the end of the third quarter. Score is 38-45. Well, we lost a little ground on that one that time, but when we were patient, we got good shots and we made them. Third quarter sponsors again were Marion Boosters, Marion County Ace Hardware, Carlson's Grocery, and Hannaford Abstract. Fourth quarter sponsors are Marion Dye and Fixture, Edward Jones Investments, and the Lumberyard. And a quarterly report.
Yeah.
Was brought to you by St. Luke Hospital.
The at number three, slashing to the basket, picking up those couple quick buckets did not help.
And he's had about five of those.
Yep. And then, like you said, on the offensive end, we just didn't do what we did in the second quarter.
No.
Which maybe switching to that zone, maybe that's why
they did go to a zone. That was a great shot by Dalrymple.
That was a nice cut by Dalrymple. Great entry pass. And
yeah.
Well, they got right up and in.
They got the ball in the short corner, and the guy from the top of it just dove right through there. That's always open.
Looks like the Warriors are going to start the way they finished the third quarter. Zinn, Stuklik, yep. Dalrymple, Stringer, and Evan Heiderbrick. One junior and four sophomores.
Okay. Hutch Trinity has a...
Jump there you ball. Go, there jump go. Ball. Nice job by
Stringer. He's got a new kid in there. Hasn't been in there all day long. Number 33.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Warriors press the ball forward. Stuklik wisely backs that
yeah.
one.
Yeah. All right.
A little bit of an errant pass there. Almost picked off. Goes off out of bounds out of Trinity. Stuklik takes a three.
We'll take it.
That was a step back three for Stuklik. Leads
that's
to four.
Case and Son Insurance three pointer. Sam needs to keep his feet on the ground. You can't adjust when your feet are in the air. Not got his hand on that one. Well, I'd like to know what their three-point percentage is. It's pretty good tonight.
Yeah. Lead back to seven. 6 minutes, 50 seconds to go in the game. And Sam picks up a foul on the Trinity.
Keep attacking that. All right, we got four new people coming in. Peyton Heiderbrick, Mason Peterson, Mr. Murmis and Mr. Baldwin, Nathan and
Sam Zinn's going to be the only one.
Blaine,
on
sorry, Blaine, I couldn't remember your name right away.
For the Warriors, nice pass. Oh. That's
nice
what the
big
block. Guy can do. That's a big wingspan for Murmurs to get over. Oh. Whoa. Okay. interesting call from the official on the other side of the floor.
Yeah.
Third personal, fourth team foul.
I don't know if he did anything at all. But evidently that official saw it, so. He had a better angle than I did, so I'll give him credit for it.
He found it.
Nice job by Peyton. Turnover Trinity. Still 7-point lead, 6:03 to go in the fourth quarter.
Keep the ball moving. Don't dribble too much.
Three-pointer from Zen. Got it.
We'll take it. You notice how that ball comes from the inside out. We make those shots. I mean, seems like it's easier to make them. You kind of catch them in rhythm. A great job by Blaine recognizing.
Oh, and a steal. Oh.
I would call
a
foul.
That's going to be a foul on
that.
25. Nice hustle by Sam Zen.
That was being very unselfish down there by Blaine. He had the ball in the paint there. He knew he didn't have a shot. Had his back to the basket. People were collapsing on him.
Yeah, I think if it was against anybody else, Blaine would probably go ahead and try to take that shot. But knowing that he's got 6'8 wingspan right behind him, he wisely tossed that ball back up top. Okay, Trinity back into man. Lead is 4 now. 5:20 to go in the game. Nice quick move by Sam. Gonna get a foul. Not sure who they're gonna call here. I think it might be number 3.
Foul call number 3 of yep. Trinity.
On the floor?
On the floor.
Checking in for Hutch Trinity, number 31, Jack.
Okay, we've got a replay coming up. Drives down there. I thought he was shooting the ball, to be honest with you.
He must have called it a lot earlier than that. Nice hustle by Nathan after the block. Nice hustle by Baldwin.
Yeah, that was fought pretty
hard. Got
the
ball, blocked, but he kept after it. Got the ball back on the tip and then ends up getting a foul on number 3 again. He picked up 2 quick fouls for Hutch. Trinity staying in the man. Got a little out of control there as he drove the baseline.
Yep.
Right idea. He just didn't have any. Once he got up and out of bounds, he didn't have a lot of options.
That one-hand pass is tough, but it's hard to throw two hands when you're sliding out of bounds. Oh, it's all right.
Well, at least Nathan picked up a foul that was worth it.
Yep. Yep. Got 3 guys getting ready to check in. Peyton Heidenbrand's coming back in, and we got our dynamic duel, Stringer and
Dalrymple.
I just went blank. Of course, my wife will tell you that happens all the time.
Well, as long as you haven't forgot her name yet, Jerry.
Yeah, well, wife. I'll tell you what, when they were playing man and Stringer was out on the perimeter and Dalrymple was underneath the basket.
Oh, nice defense. Dalrymple and Stringer combined for a steal there.
We did a lot of damage, so if we did the same, they're still in man.
Yeah, if Stringer can pull number 30 out away from the basket, it really leaves a nice opening for either Dalrymple or Stu to make a cut to the basket. Going to call Stuklitz for the charge there.
Okay.
You know, if you're going to call it that way, you better call him the other way, too.
We'll see what happens here.
Replays continue to run here. It's coming up right after this. This is where Stuklitz makes his
move. We got a Tampa State time back.
Makes a nice crossover dribble move right to the middle. Oh, wow. No, I don't think so. Stu was up in the air before number 30 was set.
Questionable, I guess. Well, we got a Tampa State Bank timeout. And one more time, fourth quarter sponsors are Marion Dye and Fixture, Edward Jones Investments, and the Lumberyard, and our Warrior sponsors are Marion Auto Supply, Gambino's Pizza, HRK Store, and KD Insurance. And we got a four-point ball game.
4:15 to go. Right now, the Warriors, as far as the guys that are on the floor, Dalrymple with 14 points. Stuklik with 11. So we have two of our higher scores for the evening out on the floor right now. Once again, if Stringer can get number 30 pulled up even to the top side of the lane, I think that's really going to open up something maybe underneath.
Looks like we might be going man.
We are going man. Stringer doing a nice job keeping 30 on his backside. Trouble is they could throw up over the top.
Somebody's got to be covering that backside, mm-hmm. helping him out because he's going to front him. They're going to lob it. You got to have somebody come from the backside.
Well, 4 minutes to go, and Trinity's going to start shooting 1-on-1 here.
Stuklik picked up his fourth foul?
Yes.
Okay.
The only other foul trouble for the Warriors right now is Peyton with 3.
I'll say one thing. We're playing about 9 people, so.
Boy, Stringer just would have stayed out front there. Dalrymple had a clear to the basket. I think they're going to call Dalrymple on that one.
Probably. Stringer kind of made up his mind he's going to go up with that ball no matter what. I don't
blame
him.
It's a free ball. You have to go after it. Yeah.
Oh, they're going to call a foul
red. They're going to call on red?
Call number 20 is Marion. No,
that's what I thought. Yep.
Third personal 18.
Yeah. Still a four-point ball game. 3 minutes, 34 seconds left to go. 18 fouls on the Warriors and 6.
Can you hear me?
Yep.
I can't hear anybody.
6 fouls for Hutch Trinity. 31 at the line, misses the front end. Warriors with the rebound. Warriors moving the ball. Trinity still in a man-to-man. Dalrymple gets the ball low. Nice bank shot off the glass. 2-point Trinity lead, 3:10 to go in the game.
All right, I'm back.
Warriors continue to stay in a man-to-man.
Whether you want me back or not.
Welcome back. Got the ball inside. He's a big guy.
He's got to have some help. He's got to have some help.
4-point lead again, 2:50 to go.
I'm sure coach is thinking if we go zone, they'll just set out front and pass the ball around. And
nice move again by Dalrymple. Gets his own rebound. Not there again.
White ball. That's all right.
Going to stay here?
Right.
I think he's going to call a foul. He is.
Foul ball on number 3 of Hutch Trinity.
So, Stringer will be shooting a 1-1.
Should be 1-1.
Four
fouls on number 3.
Which this quarter, if number 3 hasn't put on the show there, he did in the third quarter.
No.
He's just made his way to the bench, so. Stringer missed the front end of the 1-on-1. And once again, Warriors didn't quite get back on the transition. Got beat down the floor for an easy layup for a big guy.
That's 30. A 4-point turnaround. We should have had 2. We got to make free throws when you're behind. Got to make free throws. Oh, go up with it, Stu.
Nice pass to Evan underneath for 2. Warriors back down by 4. 2:10 to go in the fourth quarter. Warriors still in the man.
Got to help Stringer out.
Stringer's keeping him on the backside. And pretty good pace, but
he's trying hard, but he's. Be
Hutch
ready,
not,
be ready for the lob, Stu. Be ready. Yeah. You guys back here, be good. Nobody's on the back side.
Yeah.
Stringer lost him.
Yep.
He's battling his butt off down there. I don't know what else he can do. Doesn't have any help on the back side.
Yeah, but you know, here we are with a minute 30 to go in the fourth quarter, and that's Stringer's first foul. So
yeah, but it's not like he hasn't been battling in there. I mean,
that's what I mean. I mean, unfortunately, he's been.
Probably should have called two or three other ones.
Trinity with the free throw and the miss.
What he needs to do is just get more physical with him and see if they'll call a foul. You got fouls to give.
Oh, anyway, nice move by
that's
Stringer.
That's a great move. Now
nice
we got,
move. Nice move.
Now we got to finish it off with a free throw.
We shoot.
We're going to replay. Boy, he almost walked there. That's a nice. That's
nice,
a nice score.
Very nice move.
That's a great move.
Stringer at the line, front end. Got
there
it.
There we go.
3-point ball game. Minute 25 to go. See if Stringer can cut this down to a 2-point lead.
We're in position. We've got to get a stop on the defensive end is all.
And hits the second one. Coach Edwards calls the timeout, full timeout.
Tampa State Bank timeout. And our 3-point sponsor tonight is Casey Sun Insurance. Our timeout sponsor is Tampa State Bank. And our broadcast area sponsor is Lanning Pharmacy.
So what do you think, Coach? What are they going to come out in? Switch back and forth, man,
you know,
to zone, man to zone. What do you think Coach Edwards going to do?
I think we're in a disadvantage in man-to-man. I would come out in a zone, 1-3-1 trap. If they pull the ball out and make the chase, I'm going to tell the guys,
just get back.
Get into zone. I mean, get into man. You got to get into man. Come out in the zone, they may say, well, we're not, you know, they may not think about holding the ball. They may just try to do something. We were pretty good. We gave up some threes.
You know, I don't think with only a 2-point lead, I don't see Trinity going into a stall.
Maybe,
too much time left on the clock.
They might be very patient.
I think they might try to be patient.
I would be tempted to try the zone, but be prepared to jump into man if I had to. But I just think
we are coming out in a man.
Poor Stringer, they're expecting an awful lot from him.
Staying in a man here. Minute 15 to go, still 2-point deficit for the Warriors.
And they gotta be ready to collapse on 30 if he gets the ball though. We got to double him as soon as he touches the ball, like right now. Okay, all right.
Well, the trouble is that is the 10th foul on the Warriors, so it's going to be a two shots either way, whether it's on the floor or shooting. But at least it wasn't an easy 2 points.
Yeah, but we were coming with a double from this backside over here. Baldwin was coming to double.
That's the first one. 3-point lead for the Trinity.
We still got to be patient. We can't just run down there, dribble, and throw the ball up.
It's the second one. 4-point lead, 56 seconds to go.
But we can't take all day either.
Trinity setting up in their own man-to-man.
No, that's not what you
want.
Yeah,
that's not the shot we were meaning to really be taking.
You can't challenge the big boy.
Now you almost have to foul here.
That really hurt us there. I think we had better options, but you know what? He's playing and I'm not. It's always easy to make those decisions up here.
Two possession game here, 30 seconds to go on the clock.
No matter what he does, it's still a two possession game.
This is the front end.
Okay.
Need to box out and make sure we get this rebound here.
You know, he did a good job. He made that fake, and the guy didn't take it, so that's when he probably should have kicked it out. I mean, he was right where he should be. If the guy had taken the fake, he possibly could have gone to the free throw line.
Trinity takes a timeout here with 30 seconds to go.
Kemper State Bank timeout. Well, at least I've enjoyed watching the kids tonight. And by no means do I think the ball game's over. We still got plenty of time to do something, but we've shown we have a hard time scoring when we have to get in a hurry. When we were patient tonight, I thought we looked as good as we've looked all year.
You know, this might be one of those times where you actually maybe look at putting Dalrymple back in, and he's had a good go at underneath him, keep him and Suplik and Stringer in there, and maybe in the first 10 seconds try to pick up a quick two.
Yeah. Quick two.
Get a foul. Keep it within that two-point margin and hope they miss some free throws. Two-possession margin.
I don't think they can challenge 30. I think he's shown that he can, unless we can get him off his feet.
Well, I think, early in the game, early in the third quarter, especially we mentioned, if they could just pull him out away from the basket just a little bit.
Yeah.
Our backside cutters and the guys making some moves were in position when they got him pulled away. 30 seconds to go. Warriors down by 5. Nice pass and the easy quick two. There it is.
There it is.
21 seconds to go. So it's like 9 seconds to go with that 2 points.
Just what the doctor ordered. Now we need a steal.
Steal.
Look at this pass. What a pass this is. Boom, right between three people.
Yeah, great pass by Little Heidelberg.
Yep. So that's what we did. We got a Tampa State Bank timeout, and that is the last of our timeouts. Trinity has 2. I think you got a.
Well, I think you go for the steal, and if you don't get the steal in the first couple seconds, you foul.
Maybe, I don't know if they have a poor free throw shooter or not, but if they're dumb enough to throw it to him, that's fouling. I tried to figure out who's going to be, who we're going to foul during the game. Obviously, I don't have the stats the college have where you can figure out who's the poor foul free throw shooter before the game starts, but you could pick somebody out that has a bad form or maybe has missed a couple.
You know, from what I've seen tonight, in this group right here, I'd almost foul number 4. He's only got 3 points on the night.
Yeah.
And he's been probably the least consistent of any of their shooters.
Could be.
Uh-oh, what do we got going here? Problem with the clock. Looks like they've got it straightened out. 21 seconds to go, Warriors down by 3. 52-55. No, nice. Looks like Stuklich's gonna foul out there. Well, what happened is Stringer stepped in front of the pass but was headed out of bounds. So he flipped the ball back in. It was kind of a who's going to get there first, and Stu and Angel got there at the same time, and they called Stu for the foul. So that is 5 on Stu.
Good ball game tonight, Stu. Nice ball game. Thought he played well.
Sam Zinn in for Stuklich.
Checking in for number 25, Alex.
Too bad these guys don't play like this all the time. I think there's 2 or 3 games that they lost they could have won.
Oh, at least.
Just, they worked the ball inside. I thought they.
Back to a 5-point game.
Played pretty good 19 defense.
19 seconds to go.
Okay, we'll take that.
Well, 3-point shooting foul for Mason. Well, that'd be huge if he could knock down all 3 right here.
Yep. But I mean, just these kids, it's so much difference in this game tonight and the game a game against Sedgwick. It was just, it's night and day. Completely.
Oh, this is the first. Two more coming. Even if he can get two out of three here,
yep,
still keeps us back to a one possession game.
Yep. We got another Tampa State Bank timeout, and that was Trinity's because we're out. And I think I've done all the sponsors. Anything you want to say, Darren? I mean,
well, I think you've hit them all the way through
right.
The game.
Twice. You want me to do them again? Oh. You guys can't hear him, but I'm talking to our director over here. He's in my head. He's asking me questions, and I'm answering them, and you're probably thinking, what's he talking about? And so anyway.
5-point ball game, 14 seconds to go. We come back out of this timeout. Mason Peterson will be at the line to shoot two more. Right now, the lineup that Coach Edwards has on the floor is not our high-scoring lineup. Of course, Duke Legault just fouled out.
Well, I'd say we probably got...
But he does have the three-point shooting
lineup. Three-point shooter on lineup, yeah. And of our big men, Baldwin may be our best outside shooter.
Okay, Macy gets a second. 4-point game, 14 seconds. And gets the other one. So it's now a one possession game, 14 seconds.
Get a press, 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 get a press. Oh, luckily they still had a timeout.
Woo, that would have been a nice perk.
That would have been nice if we got a 5-second call.
Oro. If they were out of timeouts.
Yeah, well, that's what we got. But that's a Tampa State Bank timeout.
Last one. Very another, last one of the game.
Another plug for Tampa State Bank. But
3-point ball game, 14 seconds. That was good pressure. Very good pressure by the Warriors.
To get it
on the
set
inbound.
Up.
There was no good wide opening. He would have to force it no matter which of the four he threw it to.
Usually when I was coaching, I always tried to have somebody checking in for the shooter or for somebody after he handed the ball,
up.
So when they buzz the buzzer, give us time to set up our press.
Yep.
They had to run right into it. I think he had the kids out there he wanted, the quick kids.
I think the nice thing there was that ball bounced around on that free throw a little bit, so it gave time.
Yep.
You know, by the time it came through the net, Trinity couldn't exactly just grab it and go right out of bounds to get it back in. So we'll see what happens here with Trinity. See. Gone to a different set play to try to get this ball in.
I'd be surprised if they don't go long.
Yeah, that's kind of what I was
Number
thinking.
Number 30's hanging out down here at the end. Somebody better pay attention to him.
Better get behind him, Stringer.
Well,
yeah, behind him.
He's going to want to come up, I think.
I think he's going to come up and set some picks here. Need to foul him quick now. There you go.
Yeah, wasted 4 seconds there. I don't know why he didn't foul him right away. Trying to steal the ball. Maybe they thought they'd get a trap.
This is the one I said earlier we needed to foul. We'll see if I was totally wrong or not here.
Yeah.
Number 4 was one of the starters, and he only has 3 points on the night.
25 just came in. I don't know if he was one of the starters or not.
I don't believe so.
I have to look here.
Well, I guess that was the wrong person to foul.
He wasn't, no.
4-point game, 10 seconds to go. Warriors need a rebound and get it down the floor quick.
I'm not sure there's anybody out there that would have been an easy foul. Okay.
Ooh, well, we're going to go shoot some free throws with no time running off the clock.
That was good.
We're going to get 2 free throws out of this. This will be the 10th team foul on Trinity. 30 picks up his second foul. Too bad we couldn't have got him in foul trouble way earlier in the game.
I don't think he plays that hard.
I don't think he plays that way.
No.
He doesn't play physical on the defensive end.
And he doesn't go, well, he might go with people back, but we'll see what happens if he goes against somebody's own.
Nice shot by Stringer. Back to a 3-point game. See if we can cut it to 2 here. 10 seconds to go. Peyton Heidebrick getting ready to check in. And gets the second one.
Right.
2-point ball game, 10 seconds. Heidebrick checking in for Baldwin. I think that's exactly what you're talking about, Coach. Gave us time to set up the press.
Switch.
Ah, left the middle open.
Two people switch.
Oh. Yep.
Not much you can do there.
That's the one time Stringer probably should have come off a 30. And
I probably would have. I'd tell my player, don't shoot. Don't need to shoot. Just dribble out and around. Ball game's over. Oh, they could call that a intentional foul.
That's what I thought maybe they
would. He pushed him from behind.
4-point game. 2 seconds left.
No. Tried to draw the foul.
A 3-point shot.
Well, like I said, guys, if these they'd play like that every time.
There's no such thing as a quality loss. No way, shape, or form. But if you're going to lose, at least you lose. You went down fighting and played a good, hard game. Other than that 11-1 run at the beginning of the game, we played solid.
Yeah. We probably outplayed.
You know, that's what really got us in trouble.
Didn't come out.
Came out in that 1-3-1, and as soon as we got out of it the rest of the game, whether it was 2-1-2 or, man, we played heads up with them.
Played pretty well. Yep, well, for Darren and Jerry and Jay and Gene, we'll say goodnight, and don't forget to come out to support these kids every chance you get. And they said I needed a handle, so I'll use Frosty's old one. Let's keep the main thing the main thing. Good night.